Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss numerical problems on support reactions. Last classes we started about what are the different types of support and the corresponding reactions, and we have seen the equilibrium equations. We are discussing rigid body in two dimensions. Whenever we say rigid body, it is subjected to coplanar non-concurrent forces. Subjected to non-concurrent forces. Forces acting at different points. They do not meet at a common point. It's called a coplanar non-concurrent force system. This is a general support we are using in real life. Roller support. Roller support, no, we are using computer table. The bottom of the table, there is a four roller is now. It's called a roller support. What is the purpose of roller? It gives vertical reaction. It gives vertical reaction. When you say vertical reaction, it resists vertical loads. Understand? So the body is able to resist vertical loads. So it has only one reaction. Pin joint or pin support or hinge support. See the next one. Sharply, no, pin joined. Best example, our stud. Stud is connected, no, pin joined. Small pin is inserted our ear, no? The bottom of the ear. In Tamil, we are doing kadu guttu vila. No, there is a small, the pin is supported. Whenever pin jointed, it gives two reactions. One is horizontal reaction, another one vertical reaction. It means it can resist the body from vertical loads as well as horizontal loads. And the fixed support. We are using connector, no? We are hanger or nail, we are fixing on the wall or roof. Okay. So the fixed support, it gives three reactions. Horizontal reactions, vertical reaction, and one coupled moments. So it resists the body from fell down. When horizontal load is applied, it resists. When vertical load is applied, it resists. Sorry. And couple moments. When any rotating on the body, it gives couple moment in opposite direction. Then simple support. Just support. For example, if we are picking the any food packet and resting on your head. It's called a simple support. Okay, simple means there is just we are putting on the head on the support. This is called simply support. When simply support is given, it gives only one reactions, vertical reaction. So you have to remember, whenever there is support, there is a roller support, pinned support, fixed support, simple support. The pinned support, other name hinged support. This is the free body diagram. Simple support gives only one vertical reaction, RY. R means reaction, Y means Y direction. Roller support. Roller support also gives vertical reaction, RY, reaction in Y direction. Hinged support or pin joint, it gives two reactions, RX and RY. RX means reaction in X direction, reaction over one Y direction. Then fixed support. You see fixed support. It gives two reactions, Rx, Ry, and this called coupled moment. This called coupled moment, M means. So clearly, you have understood. Simply support gives only one reaction, vertical reaction. Roller support gives only one vertical reaction. Hinged support, pin support gives only one vertical reaction. One vertical reaction, horizontal reaction. Fixed support, one horizontal reaction. One vertical reaction and one coupled moment. There is a load is different types of load is acting on the beams. Beam is a horizontal structural member. What is beam? It is a horizontal structural member. Is called beam. See any structural member or anything is horizontal. We can consider as a beam. anything horizontal we can consider as a beam. When horizontal, oh, it carries only vertical loads. Okay, the so W, you know, capital W, point load. Okay, there is a degree difference of load is acting on the beam, concentrated load or point load. Second, uniformly distributed load or line load. Third, uniformly varying load. These are the point loads example. See here, 500 newton, 300 newton, and 800 newton acting at a particular points is called a point load or concentrated loads. Okay, the W1, W2, W3 is called a point load or concentrated load. See the second one. This is called uniformly distributed load. Whenever symbol like this one given, okay, you have to consider this is uniform distributed load. That unit newton per meter. Understand? UDL unit in newton per meter. Point load unit only newton. Only newton. See, point load means force, vertical force. This uniform is a vertical force, but this is a uniform distribution. No, then only we are telling the unit name newton per meter. You see here, third, uniformly varying load. The load is minimum to maximum or maximum to minimum. So any point load acting, you no need to worry about. Just keep it as it is. When uniform distributed load acting, you have to convert point load. Okay. When uniform distributed load is acting, you have to convert point load. How do you convert point load? Consider rectangular area. And the load is like, consider rectangular area. Therefore, rectangular area, capital W equal to length into height. That is small w into L. Okay. Remember, any UDL is acting, you have to convert point load. How do you convert point load? Consider rectangular area, length into height, W into small W into L. Where it is acting on the beam? The middle of the load, middle of the UDL. What is the middle of the UDL? Here, UDL is acting full length. Therefore, what is the middle of the UDL? L by 2, L by 2. Students, keep in your mind, very, very important point. When UDL is acting, convert point load, then it's located on the beam. The middle of the distance. L is acting, the W is acting throughout length. Therefore, I have marked as this L by 2, this left side, and the L by 2 right side. So the point of acting middle of the beam. Okay. This is our first step for solving the problem. Then this is called a uniformly varying load. The load is varying from left to right to left, minimum to maximum. This unit newton per meter. This look like a right angle triangle. Okay, this also uniformly varying load. So how do you convert point load? Consider triangular area. Consider the load diagram as a triangular area. Therefore, point load equal to area of the triangle. What is area of the triangle? Half into base into height. Therefore, half into L into W. See here, half into W into L. The point load equal to W L divided by 2. Small W divided by 2. Capital W means point load. Small W means that is uniform varying load. Then where it is locating, where it is acting on the beam? Center of the triangle. Students understand center of the triangle. How do you locate center of the triangle? This is the standard formula. When triangle like this shape, you have to take from L by 3 distance from left. Then balance distance 12 by 3. Or when triangle look like this one, from left from 2L by 3, L by 3. Students understand L by 3 or 12 by 3 based on this orientation of the triangle. Orientation. Which orientation you have to choose it? Triangle only L by 2. So rectangle L by 2 distance, center. For triangle, it may be L by 3 or 2L by 3 like this. Okay. Keep in mind. Then we know. We started to solve the beam problem, support reaction problems. Today also we are discussing. Students understand this one? Up to this, we recollected what we discussed last class. Okay. Now class representative, read the question. Class representative.
Yes, sir. A simply supported beam, AB of 6 meter span, is subjected to loading as shown in the figure. Find graphically or otherwise the support reactions at A and B.
Okay. You see the diagram. See this diagram I have taken from the book only. See the example 12.4. Okay. So for your understanding, I have drawn the different color. There is a support AB. So the reaction RE and RB. At a C point, one point load is acting. At C point, one point load, 4 kN. At a D point, 4 kN is acting. Another point load. You see here the distance between C and D. There is a one UDL is acting. UDL at a 1 meter distance. See here, in between C and D, one UDL is acting. So I told you, you have to convert point load. How do you convert point load? Consider the UDL as a rectangular area. Therefore, length into height. What is length? 1 meter. So up to 1 meter only the UDL action. Therefore, length into height. 1 into 2. See here, 1 meter into 2 kN/m. Therefore, meter cancel. The answer 2 kN. Where it is acting? The middle of the 1 meter. See, understand? Middle of the 1 meter. See here, diagram. I marked. I have taken separately. I calculated within mind. The UDL I have converted. Fine. How do you convert point load? Consider rectangular area. 1 meter into 2 kN/m. Meter consider for 2 kN. It will be acting on the middle of the 1 by 2, 1 meter distance. Therefore, I divided the 1 meter divided into 0.5 meter. Then you see here E2B. E2B, what is this look like here? Uniform varying load. This load is called a uniformly varying load. How do you convert point load? Triangle area. What is triangle area formula? Half into base into height. Half into base into height. What is the base? 3 meter. So half into 1 by 2 into 3. What is the height? 2 meter. So 1 by 2 into 3 into 2. 1 by 2 into 3 into 2. Therefore 2 cancel. What is the answer? 3 kN. Students here. 3 kN. How did you get this in 3 kN? Triangular area of 1 by 2 into 3 into 2. Therefore, 2 cancel, the balance only 3. Therefore, the unit becomes 3 kN. Where it is acting? See here. Whether 2L by 3 or L by 3. It look like a 2, this diagram. See that, this diagram. From therefore, from E to 2L by 3 distance. What is the L? 3 meter. 2L by 3? 2 into 3 divided by 3. Therefore, 2 meter. See here. 2 meter. 1 meter L by 3. See this formula, no? See the left right diagram. This look like a triangle. Therefore, center distance 2L by 3. What is L given here? 3 meter. Up to E to be L 3 meter. Therefore, 2 into 3 divided by 3. 2 meter. Similarly, L by 3. 3 by 3, 1 meter. So, I divided. See here, this diagram. 2 meter, 1 meter. Students understand? So, here one uniform distributed acting between C and D. C and D. The distance 1 meter. So I want to convert point load. Then only we can solve the problem. How do you convert point load? Consider this this CD, the height, no, 2 meter. Rectangular area. Therefore, length into height. 1 meter into 2 kN. 2 kN acting at the middle of the that's rectangle. What is the middle? 1 by 2 middle. How much? 0.5 meter. Then at T, 1 point load. Then I marked 1 meter. D, 1 meter. Then EB is look like a uniform varying load. Uniform varying load, you have to convert point load. How do you convert point load? Half into W into L. Therefore, half. What is the W? That is height? 2 kN meter. So half into 2 kN per meter into L, 3 meter. Therefore, the final answer 3 kN/m. 3 kN. Final answer 3 kN. Where it is acting? Students, where it is acting? It's looking like a triangle, you know, like one. This is therefore 2L by 3 distance. 2 into 3 divided by 3. Therefore 2 meter. L by 3, 3 by 3, 1 meter. So I marked here. 2 meter, 1 meter. Kavi, you understand this one? Kavi Raja?
Yes, sir.
Any question?
No, sir.
So are you clearly understand how do you convert UDL into point load? Then UVL. UVL means uniformly varying load. And the distance. Okay, center distance. For rectangle, center distance L by 2, L by 2. Therefore, I divided the 1 meter divided by 2. This 1 meter, CD distance 1 meter, no, I divided it to 0.55 marked. But this is a uniform varying load. So uniform varying load, triangle. It look like this one. Therefore, 2 L by 3 and L by 3. So L means up to the load distance, 3 meter. Therefore, 2 into 3 divided by 3, 2 meter. So I mark balance 1 meter. Therefore, the equilibrium equation for coplanar non-concurrent force system. So we know, we have to assume the given beam. The given beam is in equilibrium. Therefore, summation of horizontal force equal to 0. Summation of vertical force equal to 0. Then the third equation, summation of m equal to 0. This is a rigid body, no? Students, rigid body, this is the equation for rigid body equation. Summation of h equal to 0. Summation of v equal to 0. And summation of m equal to 0. Vignesh, any horizontal force is acting? Any horizontal? Acceleration force is acting on the beam? Can you tell me? Any horizontal force? Asaj Mohammed? Asaj? Any horizontal force is acting on the beam? Any horizontal force? Any horizontal force acting on the beam?
No, sir.
No. Okay. Therefore, we can directly write summation of H here. No horizontal force acting. Therefore, summation of H equal to 0. Now, second equilibrium. See how to use one by one. First, I am writing summation of H 0 separately here. There is no horizontal force. That's why you can neglect it. You have to neglect the first equation. Now, see the summation of vertical force. What are vertical forces? RA. The RA, see the arrow mark, goes to the vertical y direction. Vertical y means what? Plus y, no? Therefore, RA plus. See here, RB. RB, vertical y direction. So, positive y direction. RA plus RB. Other forces are vertical downward. Vertical downward means minus y direction. Therefore, minus 4 kN, minus 2 kN, minus 4 kN, minus 3 kN. See here, minus 4 kN, minus 2 kN, minus 4 kN, equal to 0. See, we have already assumed the beam is equilibrium. Therefore, we write all the values vertical direction equal to 0. Therefore, RA plus RB. So here, see here, all the minus, no. Therefore, 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. Therefore, all are minus, therefore, minus 13. Equal to 0. Therefore, RA plus RB, you take out this minus 13, the right side. So, therefore, plus 13. Consider, this is equation 1. So, we have used summation of H equal to 0, summation of V 0. What is the third equation? Summation of M equal to 0. Students, what is the summation of M? Net moment or resultant moment with respect to reference point. So, we have to use the third equation, summation of M equal to 0. What is M? Moment. I told you, whenever you are taking moment, kindly fix the reference point. Kindly refer the, fix the reference point. Here, reference point, here we can choose any reference point. A, B, C, D, E. But for this type of problem, students, for this type of problem, you can choose A or B as a reference point. A or B is a reference point. Generally, we have to use the first point. A point is the reference point. Okay. Therefore, you have to write the equation again. Summation of MA equal to 0. That means, with respect to A, all forces value must be 0. Then only the beam is in equilibrium. So, we have chosen a reference point. A point. Then, now take the moment. I told you, before going to take the moment, you have to identify which forces giving moment, which forces do not give moment. How do you identify which force do not give moment? Any force must come to the reference point. I goes from reference point does not give any moment. Students understand? Any force comes to the reference point or any force goes from reference point does not give moment. Now see the diagram. We see A is a reference point. A is the reference point. Yeah, any force coming to A? Yeah, RA coming to A. Therefore, RA does not give moment. Students, so we can neglect RA. Only this force only comes to A, reference point. So the other forces gives moment, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. So how do you identify clockwise, anti-clockwise? Put your index finger on reference point. Put your index finger reference point. And the index finger where the force is acting. See here, the reference point A. So I am putting my thumb finger on A and the index finger at C. So the arrow goes down. So I rotate, just to rotate with respect to A. Just a compass, no? We are drawing a circle. Just rotate, that's a clockwise. So clockwise means positive. Therefore, 4 into 1. What is the moment? Force in the distance. 4 into 1. See here, 4 into 1. Then 2 into reference distance. Students understand reference point distance. So A point here. Our force is F at A. What is the distance between A to F? 1 plus 0.5. Therefore, 2 into 1.5. Then the third force, 4. It's also clockwise. So 4 into that is A to D distance. Reference point to D distance. What is the distance? 1 plus 0.5 plus 0.5. So total distance 2 meter. Therefore, 4 into 2. 4 into 2. Similarly, see the 3 kN. 3 kN acting at E point. Our reference point? A point. What is the distance A to E? What is the distance A to E? 1 plus 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 1 plus 2. Therefore, 5 meter. Therefore, 3 into 5. Now, see the RB. See, RB also a force. But with respect to A, it goes to the which direction? Anti-clockwise. What is anti-clockwise moment? Minus. That's why I have written already initially. Minus RB into 6. 6 means total distance. A to B distance, no? See, for students, whenever taking moment, the reference point to the force distance. Reference point is the B. The force RB. What is the distance? Total distance? 6 meter from A. Why I have written minus? It's anti-clockwise. How can I say anti-clockwise? Just put your thumb finger at A and B. See the arrow mark. So the arrow mark goes to which direction? Upward. Just rotate. Therefore, anti-clockwise. So this is the way you can take the moment. While taking moment, you have to choose reference point. Here, generally, you have to always take the reference point starting point. Then identify which forces do not give moment. How do you compute which force does not give moment? Any force comes to reference point or any force goes from reference point. Here, this diagram, the A point is the reference point. See, any force comes to the A point, yeah, RA is coming. Therefore, neglect RA. Therefore, you have to focus other forces. So, other forces give clockwise or anti-clockwise. Just to identify. See the arrow mark, you can identify. Okay? Therefore, see here, minus RB into 6, anti-clockwise. Clockwise, 4 into 1. Then 2 into, how 1.5 came? Reference point, A to F, no? 1.5. Then D point, 4 kN. 4 into the distance, 1 plus 0.5 plus 0.5. Therefore, 2 meter, A to D, 2 meter. Similarly, 3 kN. 3 kN, what is the distance? 1 plus 0.5 plus 0.5 plus 1 plus 2. So, totally 5 meter. Then, RB into 6. Then, what is the 4 into 1? 4. 2 into 1.5, 3. 4 into 2, 8. 3 into 5, 15. Okay. Therefore, 3 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 8, 20. 20. What is the answer? Students? 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 8, 15. 15 plus 15, 30. You take out this right side, minus 30. Therefore, minus RB into 6. Minus mean cancel. 6 RB, 30. What is RB? 30 divided by 6, 5 kN. Therefore, Reb equal to 5 kilonewton. So we want Re. Already we have equation Ra plus Rb equal to 13. Therefore, we have to apply Rb in equation. Therefore, Ra plus 5 equal to 13. Therefore, Ra equal to 13 minus 5, 8 kilonewton. That is the question. Any question? Kavi?
No question, sir.
Clear, understand, cha? Clear, understand?
Yes, sir.
I repeated many times. Yes?
Yes, sir, understand, sir.
Okay, okay. Class representative, are you understand this question?
Yes, sir.
So, no doubt. Vignesh? Vignesh? Asaj Mohammed?
Sir?
Are you understand the question? Answers?
Sir.
How do you take moment? Okay. So we'll take a moment. You have to keep it in your mind. Three steps. First, you have to choose the reference point. Then first step. Second step, identify which force do not give moment. How do you identify? Any force comes to the reference point or goes for a reference point. Third point, take moment with respect to reference point. How much distance it is a force. Then clockwise means positive, anticlockwise means negative. Kavi, read the question, this question.
Yes, sir. A simply supported beam AB of span 4.5 m is loaded as shown in figure. Find the support reaction at A and B.
Okay. A simply supported beam AB of span. See, span means a distance. Students understand. So we are telling the length. Whenever support, you don't say that it's a length of the support. It is a span. Span means the distance between two support, the middle of the support. You see the support A here, support B here. From the middle of A, from the middle of B, what is the distance? This is called a span. 4.5 meter is what is shown in figure. Find the support reaction. You see, in this figure, what are the load is acting? Class, please tell me. What do you understand from the questions? The given diagram. What is in your mind now? Tell me.
See. Uniformly variable forces acting, sir. Then, one more.
What are the
beam that uniformly UDL, okay. That force is acting, sir, down.
One UDL, another one?
And one UVL, sir.
Very good, very good. Okay. So what is the UDL height, uniform distributed load height, how much?
One
kilonewton. Very good, very good. UVL height, uniform bearing load height?
That is two only, sir. Two. The arrow mark is given us completely.
Tell me.
Two only, no, sir.
I am asking UDL height. UDL height, okay, 1 kilonewton meter. Now see the diagram. You tell me, you have to tell me what is the height of uniform bearing load that I at the B point. Uniform bearing load height.
So two only, sir.
They see I have drawn the different colors. Okay. Use your mathematical skill. Tell me. Kavi?
Yes, Kavi? Sir.
What, sir, is a uniform bearing load height? Uniform bearing load height.
So one, yeah, only, sir.
How is one? Tell me.
So that is UV. That, sir, whole is two, sir. But when we cancel that UDL, means it will come one only, sir.
Then you are telling 2 meter.
So now only I just noticed that, sir.
You should have noticed early.
Yeah, it's my mistake.
I'm telling, no. This is the mind-oriented subject, concept-oriented subject. Just don't plainly memory. You have to see your third eye, no? Our Agna Chakram, there is a forehead. You know, the forehead is, there is another eye is there, no? Forehead. Okay? Okay, therefore, you have to see with three, with brain also. First two eyes, third is brain. Kavi, are you understand? What you are understanding from this question? Can you tell me? What is your in your mind after seeing this question? Kavi?
Sir, there is a 45 mm length beam, sir.
You are telling me.
Sorry, 4.5, sir. 4.5.
Okay, 4.5 meter length. Okay, beam.
Yes, sir. Then it is a simply supported beam, sir.
Very good, very good. Support and simply support, okay.
And we want to find the support reaction at A and B, sir.
That is okay. I see the load. Based on the load, what do you are understanding?
Sir, we want to convert into point load, sir. It is UDL.
How many load is acting there?
Sir,
only UVL.
Sir, UVL also, sir. Rectangle and triangle.
Very good. So, how do you convert this UDL into point load? Uniform distributed load into point load. Tell me from the figure. How do you convert distributed load into point load? Where it is acting? Tell me.
Sir, we want to convert point load means rectangular sir.
Rectangular area. Okay. Tell me rectangular area now. Tell me rectangular area for this diagram. What is rectangular area? What is general rectangular area formula?
Sir, rectangular area of half into LB.
Rectangular area. Yeah. Rectangular.
Yes, sir. Sir. The rectangular is L into B, sir. Length into breadth.
Okay. What is the length here?
Length 4.5 meters, okay. Sir.
What is the height for UDL? What is the height?
One, sir.
Okay. Therefore, 4.5 into 1 kilometer per meter. What is answer now?
4.5
into 1. What is answer?
4.5, sir.
4.5 kilonewton. Okay. Where it is acting?
Center.
Point, where it is acting?
Middle.
What is the middle value? 4.5. What is the middle? 4.5 divided by 2. How much? 4.5 divided by 2. How much?
Sir,
Do you have calculator now?
Yes, sir.
4.5 divided by 2, how much?
Sir, 2.25, sir. 2.25.
2.25, okay. See, yes. So, 4.5 kilonewton. Where it is acting? Middle of the rectangle. What is the middle of the rectangle? 4.5 meter by 2, therefore 2.5 2 meter, that's the left side, 2.5 right side. So one UDL is over. It also carries uniform bearing load. Class superstitive, convert a uniform bearing into point load. Now, where it is acting? Class superstitive?
It is 2L by 3.
What? First convert point load.
Half into base into height.
Okay. Half into base, how much? 4.5. Half into base, 4.5. How much height?
One.
See here, total height is 2 meter. Already 1 is over, no? Therefore, we have the balance, rose color. See the rose color height, only 1 meter. Therefore, half into 4.5 into 1 meter. What is answer?
2.25
kilonewton. Where it is acting? See the triangle shape. Students, see the triangle shape. Which triangle? Come to here. Which triangle? Kavi, which right. triangle? Left side triangle, right side triangle? The UDUVL.
Right side, sir.
Okay. Therefore, 2L by 3 distance. And the balance L by 3. What is L? 4.5. Okay. Therefore, 2L by 3. 2 into 4.5 divided by 3. Okay, what is answer? 3 meter. L by 3 distance? 4.5. Yes, correct? 4.5, no? 4.5? Yes. 4. That means, what is the center distance? 2 L by 3. Okay? 2 L by 3, 2 into 4.5 divided by 3. What is answer? 4.5 divided by 3, how much? 1.5. Therefore, 2 into 1.5? 2 into 1.5? 3. So, I located at a 3 meter distance. So, what is the balance? See, wrongly, this is 1.5. I wrongly typed 1 meter. Okay. Totally 4.5. So, 3 over, what is the balance? So, it should be 1.5 meter. Okay, this is the, so we converted this diagram into this diagram. So, you understand 4.5, how the 4.5 kilometer coming? This is a U, uniformly distributed load. So I convert point load, that is 4.5 into 1. Therefore, 4.5 kilometer, where it is acting middle of the rectangle. Similarly, uniform bearing load. Uniform bearing load, so triangle area, half into base into height. Half into 4.5, the height balance 1 meter. Therefore, 1 by 2 into 4.5 into 1. The answer, 2 point. Where it is acting? Middle of the triangle. What is the middle of the triangle? This is the 2 L by 3, L by 3. So, L means here 4.5. 2 L by 3. 2 into 4.5 divided by 3. Therefore, 3 meter. What is the balance? See, this is 1 mean not 1, 1.5 meter. Okay. So, now we have to use equilibrium. Sum S H equal to Sum S V 0. Now, horizontal force. Leave it. Vertical force. Ra plus Rb minus 4.5 minus 2.25. See here, equal to 0. Therefore, Ra plus Rb equal to 6.75. Now, taking moment with respect to A. So, see here, with respect to A, what is the moment? With respect to A, what is the moment? Which force do not give moment? Ra is do not give moment because it goes to the reference point. Therefore, what are the other force? 4.5 into 2.25. 4.5 into 2.5. Clockwise. See here, 4.5 into 2.5 clockwise plus. Then 2.25 into distance, how much? 3 meter distance. Students, 3 meter, 2.25 into 3 meter. Clockwise. See here, 2.25 into 3 meter. Then RB. RB is the anti-clockwise. No, with respect to A. We are taking moment with respect to A. Therefore, RB into how much? 4.5 distance. RB into 4.5 minus anti-clockwise. Then after taking calculating all the values, RB into 4.5 equal to 16.875. Therefore, RB equal to 6.875 divided by 4.5, 3.75 kilonewton. Then applying equation 1. This is equation 1. Ra plus RB 6.75. Okay. Therefore, Ra plus RB equal to 6.75. We know RB is 3.75. Therefore, Ra plus 3.75 equal to 6.75. Ra equal to 6.75 minus 3.5, 3 kilonewton. Very simple question. See, we calculate very simple. But this conversion very important. This conversion, you have to use your brain and mathematical skill. See here, 3, the balance, it must be 1.5. It's not 1, 1.5. Totally 4.5, no. Totally 4.5. 2L by 3 means 3 meter. So balance 1.5 meter. Ajaj, are you understand this question? Ajaj? Ajaj Muhammad? Understand? Okay. Kavi, are you understand? Kavi?
Yes, sir. Understand, sir.
Okay, last question. Class rep, read the question. Class representative.
A beam AB of span 3 meter overhanging on both sides is loaded as shown in the figure. Determine the reactions at the supports A and B.
See, overhanging. Overhanging means, see the previous problem, see all the support at end points. But here, see here, the support at some distance from the left end. And see the support RB from right end to 1 meter distance. This is called overhanging. The overhang means some portion beyond the support. Some portion beyond the support is called over. Sorry. Okay, see, whatever the beam we are going to apply, we have equations. Okay, RA, summation of H equal to 0, summation of V equal to 0, summation of M equal to 0. See here, at E point, on point load, 1 kN. Okay, point load is acting. At support RA, at A point. See here, the 2 kN per meter. AD, no? AD, it's a UDL acting. UDL acting, you have to convert point load. How do you convert point load? 2 kN per meter into 2 meter. So 2 into 2, 4 kN. Where it is acting? The middle of the 2 meter. See here, next diagram. I converted 2 into 2, 4. Where it is acting? 1 meter distance, 1 meter distance. I divided the 2 meter into 1 meter, 1 meter. See here. Similar on point load. At a D point, there is a point load at 3 kN. And BC, see here. BC on UDL is acting. What is UDL? 1 kN per meter. So you have to convert point load. 1 into 1, 1. Where it is acting? Middle of the 1 meter. What is the middle of the 1 meter? 0.5 meter, 0.5 meter. See here. I divided. 0.5 meter, 0.5 meter. So you understand this one. Now we have equilibrium equation. Summation of H equal to 0. Summation of V equal to 0. Summation of M equal to 0. So there is a horizontal force. There is no horizontal force. Just leave it. Then summation of V. What is the summation of V? Adding all vertical forces. Any force goes upward, positive. No, plus y, no. Vertical means Fy. Plus y direction. Plus y direction means positive. Vertical downward means minus y direction, negative. Therefore, what are the positive? Ra plus Rb. See here. Ra plus Rb. Minus 1, minus 4, minus 3, minus 1. We are adding forces. Students, we are adding forces. Summation of V means we are adding vertical forces. Summation of H means we are adding horizontal forces. Here there is no horizontal forces acting. So leave it. Now adding vertical forces. Adding means if any force goes to upward plus y direction. Therefore Ra plus Rb. Minus 1, minus 4, minus 3, minus 1. See here. Equal to 0. Therefore minus 1, minus 4, minus 3. All are minus 9 adding. 4 plus 1, 7. 4 plus 3, 7. 7 plus 1, 1, 9. Ra plus Rb, 9. Then third equation, summation M equal to 0. I told you, for taking moment, choose the reference point. Students, here reference point, see, I told you, no, reference point at the support itself. Previous problem, see the previous problem. We have taken support at A point only. Here also support, where it is support? Support at A. So you have to choose support reference point. A or E or B point. Therefore, I have written summation A equal to 0. With respect to A, students, understand, with respect to A, I am taking moment. Students, understand, with respect to A, I am taking moment. So, put your hand at A, reference point. See here, the figure. A point here. What is the RB? RB here. What is the distance, total distance? A to B, what is the distance? 1 plus 1, 3. Therefore, RB equal to anticlockwise. Rb equal to anticlockwise, no anticlockwise moment. Therefore, minus Rb into 3. Students, understand, I am taking moment with respect to A. For this type of problem, you have to choose A support or B support. Here, A, I am choosing A support. So, which force do not give moment? Ra does not give moment. It is acting at a reference point. So, what are other forces? I am starting with the support, Rb into 3. See here, A to B, 3 meter, 1 plus 1 plus 1. Therefore, minus anticlockwise. See here, at the come to here, F point. F means no, 4 kN. 4 into 1, clockwise. With respect to A, students, 4 into 1. 3 into 2, see here, A to D distance how much? 2 meter. 3 into 2, clockwise. Then see here, at the G point 1 kN, no? So 1 kN. What is A to G distance? A to G. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 0.5. What is the distance? 3.5. Students, with respect to A point, the force 1 kN at G point acting, 1 into 3.5. See, the left side E point, see here. With respect to A, it is anticlockwise. Students, with respect to A, I told you, no, put your hand, put your index finger, thumb finger at A now. Now in the screen, you put your index finger, thumb finger at A point. Then, with respect to rotate E point, is it clockwise, anticlockwise? With respect to A, put your index finger at E, now rotate. Anticlockwise, no. That's why I put minus here. Minus 1 into 1.5. Why minus? With respect to A, this E point gives anti-clockwise moment, then equal to zero. Because we are using equilibrium equation, equal to zero. So after simplification, therefore, the RB into 3 equal to minus 12. You take out this plus 12 right side, minus 12. Minus means cancel. Then RB equal to 4 kN. So we have equation RA plus RB equal to 9. Now we got RB 4. Therefore, RA plus 4 equal to 9. Therefore, RA equal to 9 minus 4, 5 kN. Any question? Students? So today, we just solved three different types of beam problems. Okay. We converted the UDL into point load, then uniform variable load converted into point load, then the located distance. At which distance located, we know it's for uniform distributed load, L by 2, L by distance. For uniform varying load, it may be distance from L by 3 or 2 L by 3, left or right. You have to choose it. Then you have to use equilibrium equations.